The ozone hole is increasing day by day and is as big as Antarctica and almost covers Antarctica. Ozone depletion is alarming, and humans haven't thought about it yet. If it's totally depleted, ultraviolet rays will reach out to us easily, causing numerous health problems. But imagine if we made an artificial ozone layer. Well, it works like the original one. How do we make it? This is Imagine If, and today we will discuss an artificial ozone layer around the Earth. Our unconscious behavior towards the environment has been the root cause of environmental disasters. The ozone layer is vanishing slowly just because of our carelessness. But we might improve ourselves. A destroyed ozone layer could be recovered. It might be expensive, but we have to do this for our safety. First, humans should improve their living standards. Start thinking about the environment. Stop releasing harmful chemicals. Must grow trees as much as they can. If they don't release pollutants in the atmosphere, the ozone layer will heal automatically, with no need for an artificial layer. But if we won't do this, and the ozone layer's thickness decreases significantly, the only way to recover this will be an artificial layer in our environment. We might use ozone generators, like vacuum ultraviolet ozone generators or corona discharge methods. The first one, the vacuum ultraviolet ozone generator, produces ozone in low concentration and needs too much. Moreover, oxygen is required in this process in large amounts. We might produce ozone, but not enough to heal the ozone layer. What about the other one, the corona discharge method? It is a cost-effective method and uses ambient air instead of oxygen, but will produce air pollutants. Think about another effective method that doesn't impact the environment and will be more credible. We might manufacture an instrument for producing ozone in the ionosphere. Like producing a generator having long antennas through which a beam is released that penetrate ions in the atmosphere and increases the production of ozone there. But this process will be too much expensive, requires a lot of areas, approximately 4 times the area of Los Angeles, and will need too much power to start the engines. This power will be equal to the 8 largest nuclear power plants running right now in this world, or other sources like coal. Oil can be used, but tremendously in large quantity. This project looks costly, but it's not only for the U.S., or will heal the ozone layer over the U.S., we'll use it globally, healing the ozone layer entirely. If all the nations invest in it, this project won't be costly and distributed equally. We made nuclear and hydrogen bombs and now using them for our welfare. What about making an ozone bomb? Releasing it in the atmosphere that will spread all around and enter the ozone layer. This will become a part of it and also turn the other gases into ozone molecules. What do you think, which process will be the best and more useful?